Yes guys, let's see valuation of intangibles. A small and a simple topic when we're talking about valuation of intangibles. You can also call this as valuation of brand. Now what normally happens is when you're trying to value your intangible, the valuation of intangible is quite difficult. Because you can't see inflows of cash which are evident from an intangible asset very easily. So let's say I have a brand. I have a brand like a particular Levi's showroom. Okay, Levi's jeans. What is the value of the brand of Levi's showroom? I can't really calculate. So to calculate that Levi's showroom brand value, we'll start using a particular method. What we'll start using is, we'll start using the profits using a capitalization method. So this method is called as capitalization. Of earnings. How do we calculate this? First, always consider your profits after tax. From your profit after tax, deduct less expected return on tangible assets. Profit after tax is total profit. If I am deducting what is the return expected from tangible asset, and the balance should be return from intangible asset. Returns from intangible asset. Using a capitalization rate, let's say my capitalization rate is 10% or something like that, whatever percentage it is, then what should be the value of intangibles? My value of intangibles is C by D. Your return divided by the percentage, that is a capitalization rate. Now, if I have identified intangibles less value of identified intangibles, like I have some patents or copyrights or whatever it is, they are called as identified intangibles. I can identify them. But a brand I can't identify because there is no cost which you are paying for acquiring it. So once you reduce the amount of identified intangibles, the balance will be called as value of brand. That's it. So basically we are starting with the total profits. Reducing our return expected from tangible asset, balance can be called as return from intangible asset. Using a capitalization rate, I am identifying the total value of intangibles. If I deduct the value of identified intangibles from it, the balance is unidentified value of brand. So using the similar model, let's see point number, problem number 12 and 13. Problem number 12. Problem number 12 guys, just check. If the following information determine the possible value of brand under potential earning model, that is the same capitalization model, PBT, income tax, tangible fixed assets, identified intangibles other than brand, expected return on tangible fixed assets in lakhs, applying a capitalization rate of 25%. You just have to substitute and you will get the answers. Just do it. Can we place the values? I'll start with PBT, all rupees in lakhs. PBT is 13. Reduce the amount of tax. 3. I get PAT of 10. From the PAT, reduce expected return on tangible assets. Expected return on tangible assets. Value of tangible assets is 6. Expected return. So obviously the balance should be return on intangible assets. So my return on intangible assets is 4. Applying a capitalization rate of 25%, which is given towards the end, you just have to divide it. You get what is the total value of intangibles. E by F divided 4 by 25% is 16. Less value of identified intangibles. Identified intangibles is 10. Then the value of brand is 6. Simple computations, guys. This is clear, then how about the 13th one? Your profit after tax is directly given to you as 2500. My tangible fixed assets are 10,000 value. Identified intangibles is 1500. Weighted average cost of capital, I don't need to use that as 14%. Expected return on intangible assets is weighted average cost of capital plus a spread of 4%. Total is 18%, which is necessary for me. And then appropriate capitalization factor is 25%. All information straightforward, put across to you on your face. Use the values. In lakhs again. Directly I'll start with the PAT given. 2500. Less expected return on tangible fixed assets. What is the expected value of tangible fixed assets? Return 18% on the value of tangible fixed assets of 10,000. 1800. Then the balance 700 is return on intangible assets. Using a capitalization rate of 25%, that is what is given to us. I can identify the total value of intangibles. This is nothing but C by D. 2800. Then less value of identified intangibles. Identified intangibles other than brand has a valuation of 1500. Then obviously the remaining balance is the value of brand. Brand valuation is 1300 rupees. These questions are frequent in exams, guys. They come for 4 marks.